Hi, welcome back to Genesis Custom Savers. You know, there's a lot of different ways to make a prop seem more real. And one of those ways is rust. And I'm going to show you, using my new cabinet upgrades, how to apply a simple rust technique that looks real. All right, for today's exercise, you're going to need a couple of things, and they're relatively inexpensive. The brushes I'm going to use are just a cheap tin hard bristle brush. For the first stage, you're going to need a small soft bristle brush. And this is Testors Craft. I got this at a dollar store. It's labeled as chocolate brown 297438. Just in my experimentation, this looked like rust to me. You're just going to need to find and experiment with different paints to get the rust effect that you want. So that's one of the paints that I'm going to use. The other paint I'm going to use is this Tamiya Hull Red XF-9, and this is an acrylic paint, so that's going to work well with this acrylic paint. And finally, for the last stages, I'm going to use a very, very small amount of this silver rub and buff. I'll show you how that works a little bit later. Okay, you're going to want to do a test piece and practice with this. So this is a 2x4 that's been painted with a similar gray is what I'm going to be using as my base. I've got some of this chocolate brown on a piece of paper to use as a palette. And I'm just going to dab a little bit with my stiff brush. And the nice thing about a stiff brush is it gives you kind of a flecking effect when you do it. And of course, rust is going to accumulate on the corners. We don't want to do a spot out there. You can if you want, but for my effect, I'm just going to do a subtle effect on the corners. So that's going to be my test piece. I'm going to let that dry for about 15 minutes, and then we'll hit it with the next phase. Okay, next phase with our test piece is I'm going to apply the Tamiya paint. And thanks to Bill Duran for the tip, Bill Duran of Punish Props, putting a nut in the bottle, and you can hear it rattling around, so it almost makes it like a rattle can. Really easy to mix it up. And I'm going to carefully open that up. And with my soft brush, I'm going to get just a tiny little bit. And I want to get it off mostly an experiment, because what I want to do is just basically dab. And I want to make a flecking effect. And I don't want to paint it on. Basically what I'm going for here is I want to blend the colors a little bit. So it doesn't look like I'm using two colors. It actually looks like it's more of an organic blending of the colors. And you'll see what I mean after it's dry. Right now it goes on very dark. But once it's dry, and right on the edge, I'll paint just a little bit just to kind of get it a little stronger. Right on the edge. And of course you can play with the effect whether you want darker rust or lighter rust. You can do some parts of the prop with a darker rust, other parts with a lighter rust. Lighter, more of the light color. Darker, more of the dark color. And we will let that dry again for about 15 minutes. This acrylic paint dries fairly quickly. And then we'll do the final step. Okay, as you can see, my rust is starting to look like rust. And the final step, actually, I'm going to turn this around so you can see better. How's that? Is the rub and buff. And so what I'm going to do is you really only need a very tiny amount on your finger. And I'm going to use a cloth. I'm going to wipe some of that off on the cloth just so that there's a tiny little bit on my finger. As you can see, with the tiny little bit, as I go along, it puts a metallic edge right in spots along the surface. So it gives the impression that metal is underneath and has kind of been worn through. And with rub and buff, less is more. You get too much on there, just even a little bit, and it's going to make a nice silver streak there, which is too much, even on the edge. That doesn't look right. So you want to make sure that you've wiped it off. And once rub and buff is on, it's hard to get off. You need some kind of a paint thinner or something, because even with the cloth, it's a wax, you're just smearing it around and wrecking your prop. So you want to be very careful with the rub and buff. That's why we do a practice piece. So I've got my rust. Let's compare it to some real rust. See how it looks. All right, this is my Wasteland barrel, a prop that I built previously. It's got a really cool logo on it with the radioactive hazardous waste and some bullet holes. I stripped away the metal, and then I applied a solution that I made that actually accelerates genuine real rust. And then I hit it with a matte clear coat so it doesn't rub off. And as you can see, the rust that we've done, simulated rust, color-wise, texture-wise, looks pretty good. So I'm going to go ahead and apply this technique now to my prop and see how it looks. Now, as you might already be able to tell, I've experimented with some rub and buff a little bit in some places already, and I've hit it with my first chocolate brown coat. So what I'm doing is I'm basically just trying to think of where rust would accumulate. And if you're a prop person, you've studied props and you've looked at rusted things out in fields and on the side of the road, and you've seen where the rust accumulates. And short of bubbling paint and rust seeping out, which is a technique I'm not doing today, I'm just going for corners and edges primarily. Do a little bit of rust in here, but really I'm going to do faint. I'm going to focus on just kind of corners and edges. Got my paint and my palette here. So I'm going to dab that away, and I'm just going to even more faintly, just going to add to what's already here. And if you want to, you can rub with your finger, and that sometimes blends it in, gives you a slightly different effect. You can decide what works best for your prop. Just remember, if you're blending with your finger and then you go to touch another spot on the prop, you're going to get paint there. Again, if you're a perfectionist, you're just going to keep at it until you're really happy with what you're getting. Okay, so I've got a really nice effect going here. Now, with the rub and buff, if I add too much, it's actually going to really take away from the effect. So probably what I'll do is just hit it in the corners a little bit and then step back and take a look. As you can tell, I'm being really careful with this stuff and not wanting to do too much. That may be all I want for this. I'm gonna get right in the corner there. Do a little bit heavier right on the... Yeah, I think that's all I want for the rub and buff. Right like that. Just to kind of complete the effect. Good. So that's my finished prop. Looks a little bit more real than it did before. Still got a couple of little spots I'm probably going to touch up that I feel like I missed or that it's missing, and then it'll be done. So I hope that helps you take your prop, your project, to the next level of realism using a simple fake rust technique. If you like this kind of stuff, please subscribe to my channel, and thanks again for watching.